Hi everyone, it's Jen here. So I didn't do a 23-week update because I have cough issue that I had the week before that. As y'all saw in the week 22 video, I had a cough. Well, it stayed with me last week and it's still with me today. Turns out I have bronchitis, so I'm on antibiotics for that. So you guys will still be hearing me cough in this video and I'm very sorry for that. But last week I did not do a video because my coughing got really bad, really worse, and I just was not in the mood because I had stress issues with doctor stuff and all this other things, which, it's a very long story, which I've already tried putting in a video and it made the video a little too long. So to make that long story short, I could not be seen by my old doctor, by the doctor I was being seen by anymore, because I was my insurance was out of network. So I went to another doctor's office, which originally was my original doctor that I had for both my other two pregnancies. I was told at the beginning of this pregnancy they could not see me because of my insurance, but apparently whoever I had talked to at the beginning of this pregnancy, which was about 6 to 8 weeks, whoever I had talked to then didn't know what they were doing or what, because it turns out they do still accept my insurance and I could have been seen by them this entire time. So, but like I said, long story short, I'm now back at my original doctor's. Unfortunately, the month of July was all booked, so she could not schedule me an appointment to see my doctor until August 25th, so I still have to wait a whole month. Because of that, I went to the emergency room for my cough. Turns out I have bronchitis and I am on, like I said, antibiotics. So you're still gonna hear me, cough a lot in this video because I just started the antibiotics yesterday. it's a beginning stage of bronchitis. So even though I've been coughing for 3 weeks, it hadn't, like, I have the infection, but it hadn't gotten any worse, because, you know, bronchitis could eventually turn into pneumonia if you don't do anything about it. I'm lucky enough that it didn't get that far, even though I've had the cough for 3 weeks. So anyways, that's just a lot of stuff, a lot of stress, and a lot of stuff, issues was going on last week. That's why week 23 video did not get done. So let's move on to week 24, and then I have a little surprise to tell y'all at the end of this video. So for this video, we are using our iPad mini, because I have noticed that there's features on there that allow me to add music and text and stuff to my videos, which I'm probably going to use for the surprise. Well, I'm going to try to, but we'll see. Because of that, I didn't write my info down like I normally do, so I'm just going to take it straight off my phone. So, for this week, I'm 24 weeks along. According to this I'm 24 weeks and working on day 2 of 25 weeks, so I'm 24 weeks and 1 day as of today. Pregnant. I am on day 169, so I've been pregnant for 169 days, and I have 111 days left. Whew. So, although I'm confused, 24 weeks is technically 6 months, but it says right here for my 169, it gives me little tips for like the week or the month or anything like that. 24 weeks is technically 6 months, I believe. I'm pretty sure I'm not wrong about that. I may have to go back and look at my gestational stuff. I'm pretty sure I'm at 6 months. But it says right here, even though you're in month 7, there's nothing wrong with enjoying an occasional bicycle ride. If you were riding a bike for exercise before you got pregnant, then you should still be able to keep up with your routine throughout your pregnancy. As long as your health care provider knows your intentions and foresees no problems, continue your workouts with peace of mind. However, once your belly gets too big, you may find it a bit more difficult to pedal and may need to stop until after your baby is born. So So it says in here 7th month, but I'm pretty sure 24 weeks marks the 6-month mark, so that's a little confusing. So anyways, for symptoms, don't really have any except more frequent urination or needing to go to the restroom. Before, I could take two or three hours without needing to go to the restroom. Now I go to the restroom at least once every hour. For cravings, there's really no new cravings. I am kind of still in the fruits and vegetable craving stage, not as much as before. Like, I haven't had any watermelon in a while, although I could really use a mango right now. Thinking about fruit makes me want a mango. So I might end up going to buy one. We'll see. And then vegetable-wise, I'm really liking broccoli right now. So yeah, there's really no new cravings except for the broccoli, but it's not, I wouldn't consider it a huge craving. It's just more of, again, my 8-year-old's being my tripod and she can't seem to sit still.
Okay.
So I'm sorry if the camera's moving around a lot. She likes to hold it, and normally I see no problem with it. Okay, you are moving it way too much. Find a spot and stay in it, and then I'll give it back to you. So yeah, she likes to hold it, and I let her hold it, but
sort of.
You gotta keep it still, baby, otherwise you're gonna lose being the tripod. So where was I? Oh yeah, broccoli and all that. So broccoli, I guess you consider as new, but it's not hugely new because it's not necessarily like a huge craving. Like, I'm not purposely going out and buying it. I just noticed that whenever I've gone to people's places or have cookouts, if they have broccoli or anything like that, like, I grab a lot of it and I eat it. So I just say broccoli is something I'm liking eating right now, not really craving it. But mango, definitely. Like, I want to go out and buy one right now just to eat it.
Watermelon.
I haven't had watermelon, and I don't feel like having watermelon. I burnt myself out on the watermelon. I ate so much watermelon in the past 3 weeks that I'm just like, no more. Okay, so.
I like the watermelon.
Says that the baby size is 12.5 inches, which is the size of roughly of like a corn on the cob, like a whole corn on the cob. And then the baby weighs about 1.25 pounds. Now, I know a couple of weeks ago my baby was weighing more than what the app was saying, so I'm not sure if my baby has kept to that growth rate or if it slowed down enough to where the app has caught up to it, or it has caught up to the app, however you want to look at it. So my baby could weigh 1.25 pounds or could weigh a little bit more than that. I don't know, but that's a rough estimate, I guess you can say. Then for facts about the baby. Oh, it's not coming out. Why is it not coming out? There it goes. It says, with your little one rapidly developing senses, your baby should probably be able to tell what is upside down or right side up. And then your baby's respiratory system is also rapidly growing. Lungs are developing in preparation for breathing and actually moving amniotic fluid in and out. For now, your baby still gets oxygen through your placenta. So, it's learning how to breathe and can tell whether it's upside down or not, which makes sense because of all the movement that I get at night. When I toss and turn, the minute I move one way, the baby moves. And then if I move back the other way, the baby moves, so. It's definitely figuring out what side is up and what side is down. So that's pretty much it for that app on the fat. I like to use two apps. The other app, I only use it for like reference on the baby's size and weight, because it does sometimes vary from the other one. Sometimes they say the exact same weight and size, other times it's different. This is one of the times where it's different. It says here that the baby is 11.8 inches and that it weighs 1.3 pounds, and it's roughly the size of a large zucchini. So it's a little bit, not like a huge difference in what it thinks the size and weight of the baby is, but it still gives you a good variety, like a good like estimation of like an in-between point, I guess you can say. And that's pretty much all I use that one for. So there's that. Now let me do the belly bump shot, and then we'll get on to whatever the surprise is. Okay, so there you go, right there. So 24 week belly shot. So this is my right side. This is the front. And this is my left side. And then without the shirt, we've got left. My front. Belly button's not completely flat yet, but it's getting there. And my
wait,
left.
When you're pregnant, yeah, your belly button is
well, your stomach, it stretches out. It's stretching out. So your belly button. Some people's belly button pops out. Like a little button. It'll pop out. And then some people's belly button goes flat. Mommy's always goes flat. And then others don't really change at all. It depends on your stomach and the way the baby grows.
Then, now,
so, this. Here's the deal. My friend that I was going to do the collaboration video with the gender reveal, we almost had a plan to do it together, but then she got sick and couldn't be, and I didn't want to be around, well, not that I didn't want to be around her while she was sick, it was just since I'm pregnant and I'm dealing with my own sickness, it probably wouldn't be a good idea for me to be around her while she's sick. And she felt the same way. She was actually the one that told me, you know what, actually I'm sick today, I don't think it's a good idea for you to come over. So I said okay. She just went through a major surgery, so I don't really want to bug her. But not only that, I think either toward the end of this week or sometime next week, they're planning on going on a family vacation to California, and they won't be back until August. So I didn't want to make y'all wait that long for the gender. So my surprise is I'm going ahead and do a gender reveal. Now, I'm probably going to put it in a separate video because, like I said, I'm using the iPad, and I know there's music and stuff that can be added onto the video. So, I'm just gonna give y'all a little clue. So this is, in this box is an outfit, and that outfit is either for a boy or a girl. So, if you guys want to know what the gender of the baby is, I'd go check out video number 2. Alright. As for the baby bump date, that's the end of this video, and I will see y'all next week. Bye.
Bye.